So, Jacci, was your shop here at this location when Katrina hit?
Sure was.
Wow.
Yeah, she's been here 39 years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was here. We were the first people back tattooing with a generator till the fire marshal came in.
No kidding.
Dedication.
Tattooing with a generator.
Let me tell you what I was doing. I was hilarious. I was going around. Everybody was throwing their refrigerators out. So I would go around and draw tattoo designs on the refrigerator saying we were open. Come by and see us. It must have been insane doing all that, but I did do it. I draw tattoos all over. I mean, it's open canvas. Why not?
Yeah. And I heard they were giving money away. Like, there's people running around just spending money afterwards.
Yeah, right. I didn't get that money. I did get some money, though, but yeah. It wasn't worth my while, I'll tell you that.
Was your shop damaged at all?
Oh, yeah. The whole back end of this thing, there was no roof on the back of this building. And I had another shop on the ninth ward, you know? And that shop, oh, it was way underwater.
So you have two tattoo shops going?
I had. Not no more.
Did you never rebuilt that one when you lost it?
No. The city gives you the blues. You think it's easy. It ain't easy.
Oh, no. We know how hard it is.
The city.
Not down here, but.
The city just gives you the absolute blues. So I let that go, to be honest with you.
What do you mean by the city gives you blues?
In other words, you gotta build a code and this, that, and the other. And once you build a code, they find something else wrong. It just made it difficult to succeed, you know?
Right, right.
Whenever there's a tragedy, it seems to be like it's all about the money. You know what I mean?
Right.
And so that's what I believe happened.
It's a shame.
Especially when people are down, you know? When people are down, that's the bad part.
Hey, this is Big Dave. If you want to stay in touch, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button for all new content.